Welcome to my first lesson on my Chrome extension crash course on YouTube. And before we get started, make sure that you like this video, subscribe, and follow me on Instagram. But now, let's get started. Building a Chrome extension is really similar to building a website because we use the same files. We use HTML files, CSS files, JavaScript files, and it's basically the same thing. But the main difference is going to be using the manifest.json file, which is the most important file in your extension. Because all of the information about your extension, so things like the name, details, and all of your files, so JavaScript files, HTML files, CSS files, gets run from that file. And it's the first file that your extension checks when it gets loaded, which is what we're going to create at first. So I'm going to write manifest.json. And it's going to be a JSON file. So if you know how to use JSON, then make sure that you check out my tutorial on it and come back here. But now what you're going to want to do is scroll down and find my manifest.json template on GitHub and open that page. So I'm going to do that now, and we're going to click on the manifest.json file and copy all of this. So let's select it, copy, and now I'm going to paste it in here. And it looks pretty scary, but once I go over this, you're going to understand it and it's going to be pretty fun. So the first thing that we have here is going to be the name, and it's going to be the name of your extension. So I'm going to write Chrome extension. The second thing is going to be the version. So this is going to be the version of your extension, and you can be changing this to whatever you want. The next thing is going to be the manifest version. So this is going to be the version of your manifest.json file. And if you're not really sure what the latest version is, then you can just search it up on your browser to make sure that you have your latest version. The next thing is going to be the description. So it's going to be the description of your extension. And I'm just going to write Chrome extension tutorial. The next thing is going to be permissions, and this is going to be where we're going to put the permissions that we want to have or our extension to have. And we're not going to be going over this right now, but later. So I'm just going to set this to blank. The next thing is going to be the content scripts, and this is where we're going to put all of our files. So matches, this is going to be the website URL, so the website we want our extension to work at. We're going to set this later on. The next thing is going to be where our JavaScript file is going to be. So if we take a look here, we can see that we have a path here, and it's going to be in a folder called scripts. So let's create it. So scripts, and then I'm going to make a JavaScript file here. So I'm just going to write script.javascript, and I need to fix something here. So let's just do content script, and this is what your JavaScript file should be named. I'm going to fix this now. And then we have our CSS file. So let's create a CSS folder, not in the script folder. So CSS, and in here, I'm going to make a styles.css file. But now we're going to go back and take a look at matches. So in here, we're going to put the website URLs of where we want our extension to work at. But if you want it to work on all websites, then we're going to change this to all URLs, which is now basically going to let our Chrome extension to work on all websites. Now we're going to move on to background, and this is going to be basically like your backend for websites, but this is just going to be for your Chrome extension. And we're not going to use this for a while, so it's not really going to matter, but let's just create this file. So we're going to write background.js. And if you want to, you can put this in your scripts, but I'm just going to keep it here. And if you do, then make sure that you change the path also. Now we're going to move on to actions. And the first thing that we see is going to be the default icon, which is basically going to be the icon of your Chrome extension. And if you do have an icon, then make sure that you make a folder called assets and then name your icon icon. And you can change the file type if it's different. But I don't have an icon. And if you don't have an icon too, then we can just go ahead and remove that. And then the next thing is going to be the default title. So this is going to be the title of your Chrome extension. So I'm just going to write Chrome extension title. And then we have the default pop-up. So this is going to be the HTML file of your Chrome extension. So popup.html. And a lot of people also name it like that. But if you want to, you can just name it index.html and make sure that you change it here. And so now that we know how to use our JSON file, let's go ahead and add our extension to our Chrome browser. So open your browser and click on the three dots at the very top right. We're going to move on to the extension section and click on manage extensions. Now at the very top right here, we're going to see this developer mode and we're going to turn it on, which is going to allow us to open our folder. So it's going to allow us to add our extension. So we're going to click on load unpacked. And in here, you're going to put the path of your Chrome extension. So we can see it that in my case, it's just going to be web dev in my documents and make sure that it's going to be the same path as in here. And then I'm going to click on select folder. And there we go. So we can see that the name is going to be Chrome extension, like in our manifest file. The version is going to be 0.1. So we're going to see it here, 0.1. We're going to see that the title is going to be Chrome extension tutorial, like in here. And we don't have an icon because we haven't added it. So now let's go ahead and click on this puzzle icon at the very top. And let's pin our Chrome extension. So right now, if we click on it, we can see this tiny cube appear. And this is going to be our popup.html file. So it's going to be this file right here. And let's actually try to do something. So let's first create the bone structure of our HTML file. And I'm going to zoom in so we can see this a bit better. Now in the body, let's actually write something. So I'm just going to make an H1 and I'm going to write Chrome extension and the title. Let's set this to the same thing. So Chrome extension and take a look now. So now if we go ahead and click on this to reload our extension and click on it, we're going to see the title from our popup.javascript file. And if we do take a look here, we can see that we do have a CSS and a JS file, but they're not going to be for our popup.html file, but they are going to be for the window that we're going to be at. So let's go to our content script file and we're going to alert something. So I'm going to alert Chrome extension alert. And now we're going to go back here and let's reload the extension. We're going to see that nothing happens because this doesn't really work on any Google pages. So if I go here, it's not going to work. But if we do, let's say, go to YouTube, then we can see that we're going to get our alert. So if we go to, let's say, Wikipedia, so go here, we can see that we also get the alert. So it's going to work on almost any website. And same goes for the CSS file. Let's comment this out. I'm going to select the body. Let's change the background color to something random. So I'm just going to say dark red. And we need to set this to important to override anything or any website. So we can go back here. We need to update our extension, reload it. And it's not going to work here. But if we do go to Wikipedia, then we can see that it's going to work here. If we go to YouTube, it shouldn't work because they obviously did something. So this is kind of why most people, when they make an extension, they usually make it for specific websites, which is where the matches comes in handy. But now let's finish our setup. So I'm gonna delete this and then also this part. We can close them and let's remove the h1 from the pop-up file. And we need to add a css and a js file to our popup.html. So we can just go ahead here and write popup.js, and then we can do popup.css. And then we can go to our manifest and fix some things. So let's actually put all of our things in the right folder. So the popup.js should be in scripts. Same goes for background.js. Popup.css, we're going to put that in CSS. And now this is all going to be clean. But the last thing that we need to do is going to be fix this part. So our background.js is going to be in the script folder. So let's do scripts. And then it's going to be background.js. This looks good. But we got to go to our popup.html file. And let's link our script here. So it's going to be in the scripts. And then popup, we can link our CSS file. And then this is going to be in the CSS folder. And then the file is going to be styles.css. And last thing that we can do is going to be add bootstrap. So let's write bootstrap. And now we can see that it's going to work on this page. So that looks pretty Interesting. Let's remove that so it doesn't bother us. So it's going to be in these styles. And yeah, so it still works because we need to reload our extension and now it's going to go away. So now let's go down and we can add Bootstrap. So we got the script. Let's put the script with our own script and then the CSS. We're going to put it with our own CSS link. And so now that we're done with setting up our Chrome extension folder, making it look clean, and learning the very basics of some of the files here. So the manifest.json file and how everything else works here. This is where we're going to end this video. So make sure that you like it, subscribe to this channel so that you don't miss upcoming Chrome extensions lessons, and follow me on Instagram to stay tuned. And hopefully, see you in the next video.